First, we're showing here a 4-carbon carbohydrate that has 2 chirality centers. You can see what we typically would do to show the stereochemistry is to draw it using wedges, solid wedges, and dotted wedges. It happens to be a carbohydrate. Emil Fischer, a German chemist, in the late 1800s, was doing a lot of research on carbohydrate chemistry. And carbohydrates have a lot of chirality centers. They're larger and they have a lot of chirality centers. And he wanted an easier way to draw them and still be able to illustrate the stereochemistry. You can imagine how tiring it would be to constantly do all those wedges. So in 1891, he devised a method for doing that. And I'm going to show you that here with just the carbon backbone and then do the structure. You can see the 4-carbon compound. And what he did was he visualized it as having rotated the carbon chain back on itself and then took the molecule and spread the carbon chain out vertically and smashed it or projected it into a paper so that it was like a flat image. You see the idea over there on the left. It would be a straight line up and down with crosshatch lines. The straight line up and down represents the carbon backbone, but it's really visualized as being curved backwards at the top and the bottom on the actual molecule. The crosshatched part is the groups that are attached, and you can see on the structure they're actually coming out towards you. All of those atoms are coming out towards you that are attached. Now, normally we don't do a Fischer projection unless we have chirality centers. So here's an example of our 4-carbon carbohydrate again, and the Fischer projection on the left. You can see what you do, you turn it so it's back, curled back on itself, and then you straighten out the carbon chain, and basically then you stylize it flat. But you can see the groups are coming out towards you on the chirality centers. You see that? So what it really means when you have the Fischer projection drawing, as you can see on the left, the top is the Fischer projection. It really means the same thing as the wedges drawing on the bottom. And you have to remember that. Now, what if you had a longer carbohydrate? Well, you can see that the model actually, if you're looking at it that way, it gets totally curved back on itself. And it certainly wouldn't exist that way in any stable conformation. But it's the way we're visualizing it to do this style of projection. So notice as you go down this backbone, it starts, there's the C double bond O. You go down, down, down. Every group is showing the groups attached to the backbone coming out towards you. Sort of like you have the molecule curled up in a ball and it has all its feet sticking out on the edge on the outside. So that would be the image you should have in your mind for a Fischer projection. So if you're ever asked to compare two structures and they're given to you in Fischer projection form, you must realize that that's a projection. It's a flattened out picture of the 3-dimensional molecule. If you rotate it around to try to make it see whether it superimposes on another molecule, you want to keep it in the plane of the paper. You can't pick it up and flop it over, because if you pick it up and then rotate it left to right, flopping it over, you're going to have the groups aiming where? Towards you or away from you? Away from you, and then that won't match the other Fischer projection. but you can slide it around in the plane of the paper, like reverse the top and the bottom, just twist it around the center axis. You can do that. But you do need to keep this in mind whenever you see a Fischer projection. It means that the groups attached to the backbone are all coming towards you. And the way you can tell it's a Fischer projection, generally they'll not draw the C at that crosshatch point. It'll just be crossing of the two lines. No C there in the middle.